standing position, but first I will put your cane in your injured side. Can you scoot forward, please? Then try to push yourself to stand using your armrest. Hold your cane and walk slowly. Okay, ma'am, we're going to do the standing to sitting position. Can you move backward until you feel the top step of the wheelchair? And then try to put your arm to the armrest and sit slowly. And scoot backward.
Injury, the part cane should be on the right sides of the patient. So to size correctly the cane, the hand grip should be on the level of the patient's wrist and elbows should be slightly bent. So for a step 2 gait pattern, the left leg. The cane and the injured leg should stay together and the non-injured leg steps to them. So be sure to keep the bottom of the quad cane flat to the ground and not on an angle. Lower extremity stiffness, we want the quad cane on the right side of the patient. And as the caregivers, you'll be positioned behind the patient's weak side, one arm to the back of the shoulders, and one holding the gait belt. Also, the side is a little bit. So, stairs, we're going, the patient should step up first with her strong leg, followed by the cane and the injured leg at the same time. Down your affected leg and cane at the same time, followed by your strong leg.
To perform the stand leg position, ma'am. First, you put your arm to the armrest. And scoot yourself to the edge of the chair. And slowly, and push up your arms. Push yourself up and slowly. Put your hands here at one time. And we're going to perform the full width bearing. First is move your walker first and then use your bad leg. Next is the good leg and then repeat the cycle.
So hold that walker. Move forward the walker. Slowly and gently step your injured leg, followed by your strong leg. Repeat the cycle. not read your so hold the walker. Raise your weak leg. Then move forward the walker. Slowly and gently step your strong leg. Then repeat the cycle.
Forward your back leg and gently sit. And scoot to the scoot backward.
So the crutches are always placed on the stronger side of the patient. Ask the patient to hold onto the hand grip and also to hold onto the armrest. And then ask the patient to slowly push yourself up. Then instruct the patient to move the crutch onto the going to perform now the moving bearing in 2.8. Then both hands in the hand grip, make a triangle position, and then first to move is the right crutches together with weak leg. Right crutches and weak leg, then opposite crutches together with strong leg, then right crutches together with weak leg, opposite crutches together with strong leg. Then right crutches and weak leg, then opposite crutches together with strong leg.
So you're going to perform the partial weight bearing 3.8. So move forward with your crutches now. And then step forward with your injured leg to meet the crutches. And then the last one is your good leg. Then repeat the cycle. Walk gently and carefully.
Okay, ma'am, you're going to perform now the moving bearing in 2.8. Then both hands in the hand grip. Make a triangle position. And then first to move is the right crutches together with weak leg. Right crutches and weak leg. Then opposite crutches together with strong leg. Then right crutches together with weak leg. Opposite crutches together with strong leg. Then right crutches and weak leg. Then opposite crutches together with strong leg. Bearing in 4.8. So both hands in the hand grip. Then make sure the crutch pad to the distance of crutch pad they're accurate is 3 fingers to prevent numbness. Then make a triangle position and make sure the distance is 6 inches for their feet. Then first to move is the right crutches followed by weak leg. Then opposite crutches followed by the strong leg. Right crutches, weak leg, opposite crutches, then strong leg.
We're going to demonstrate the swing to gait and the swing through gait. Swing to gait, the patient will moving forward the crutches and swing her leg and place that at the placement where the crutches are located. In front of the patient and then swing her both legs through the crutches. For the ascending stairs position using crutches. But first, we will put the crutches in the strong side. I hold the hand grip. And while the other hand will hold the side grip. And now we will start to step up using the strong leg with the support of my hand in her back and in the shoulder. And now step up with your crutches together with your weak leg. Then strong leg and the weak leg together with the crutches. And now the ascending. In the ascending position, hand in your hand grill and weak, step down with your weak leg together with the crutches. And then the strong leg, weak leg and the crutches, and the strong leg. Ask the patient to move the crutch towards her strong side. From the patient to hold onto the hand grip and the other hand to the armrest. Instruct the patient to slowly sit on the arm, on the chair. Backwards and place the crutches on her strong leg.